Dear students, I am B. Suresh Kumar, lecturer in Zoology, working in SRR Government Arts and Science College, Karimnagar of Telangana State, that affiliated with the Shatavahana University. Today, I am going to take online classes to SEM-5 students. The subject is Zoology. The topic name is Digestion. So before going to discuss the topic, we will discuss the overall syllabus of SEM-5. So the SEM-5 zoology paper is physiology and biochemistry. It includes 4 units that covers different topics of physiology and biochemistry. The first unit include 3 lessons. The first lesson covers contents related to digestion, and second lesson covers contents related to respiration, and third lesson covers circulation. So in detail, all the contents are furnished in this slide. You have to verify this slide, and in detail the syllabus is there, contents of unit 1. And next, the unit 2. The unit 2 also include 3 lessons. The first lesson covers excretion, and next lesson covers the musculoskeletal system, and third lesson covers the contents of neural system. So these the 3 lessons are present in unit 2 in detail. You have to verify in detail, it is present in this slide. So next, unit 3 include endocrine glands, so in which structure of various endocrine glands and their secretions and regulation, mechanism of hormonal function, all these contents to be covered. And besides that, in the same unit, osmoregulation, one more topic is there. And third lesson is enzymes, definition of enzyme, classification, mechanism of function of enzymes, all these things to be covered under unit 3. The unit 4 purely include biochemistry topics. So first lesson, biomolecules, carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, nucleic acids, and metabolism of carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids, all these topics to be covered in unit 4. So this is overall syllabus of SEM-5 paper of zoology designed by Shatavahana University. So let us, we are going to discuss the first unit. The first lesson is digestion. So let us, we are going to discuss the first lesson of first unit, that is digestion. In earlier class, already you learned about digestion. So what is digestion? Everything already you know. So every organism required food material. The food is a basic requirement to all organisms. So the collection of the food material by the organisms called nutrition. So based on mode of nutrition, the organisms are categorized 2 kinds. They are autotrophs and heterotrophs. What are autotrophs? Auto means what? Self. So they can prepare their own food. Such kind of organisms are termed as autotrophs. So the autotrophs can synthesize their food by photosynthesis mechanism. They're called photoautotrophs. Some are chemoautotrophs are there. The chemoautotrophs can synthesize their food by performing various biochemical reactions. So they called chemoautotrophs, example sulfur bacteria. Photoautotrophs are what? Chlorophyll containing all organisms, chlorophyll contained bacteria, and plants, all these are comes under autotrophs. And the second variant, heterotrophs. The heterotrophs are what? They depend on other individuals for their food. So such individuals are called heterotrophs. Mostly all animals are comes under category of heterotrophs. So the chemical substances, whatever present in the food, called what? Nutrients. You observe visual. So whatever food material we consuming in our daily life, such images are provided in the slide. So that food material contain various chemical substances. Such chemical substances are called nutrients. What is the function of nutrients? The nutrients provides energy for all vital activities in our body, in the body of organism, in the body of the animals, various kinds of physiological process to be occur in our daily life. So all these physiological activities, all these vital activities require energy. For example, you are listening lesson, so listening also require energy. You are observing images, you are watching video, so that is also require what? Energy. There is one kind of vital activity that require energy. So the nutrients provide energy for all vital activities. Everything require energy, so all vital activities attain energy from the nutrients. And the nutrients are raw material for growth. So at the time of birth, the size of the individual is very smaller. In aging process, gradually the size of the individual enlarges, grows. So that is called growth. So the nutrients are raw material for growth. So for example, the food material contain proteins. The proteins are called building blocks of our growth. So they are raw material for growth. And also nutrients utilized for repair of tissue. In our daily life, millions of cells undergoes death and they replaces with new cells. For example, you observe the cells of blood. Daily number of WBC undergoes death, and after completion lifespan, the RBC also undergoes death. So at the place of worn out RBC, new RBC will be regenerated. So that is repair. For example, due to the injuries, tissues to be damaged. For example, any injury occur on skin, epithelial tissue to be damaged. So that to be repaired. So the repair of tissue also mediated by nutrients. It requires nutrients. And production of gametes, formation of sperms, formation of ova, all these are required nutrients. And protection from pathogens. Our body contain immune system. The immune system provides resistance to us from pathogens. In immune system, one of the main content, army of proteins. Army of proteins are what? Immunoglobulins. The immunoglobulins are made up of proteins. The proteins are nothing but nutrients. So the nutrients provides protection from disease. They play key role in resistance. So like that, every process, every activities, whatever occurring in our body, all these activities compulsory require nutrients. Without nutrients, the individual never survive, never lead life. So that is significance of nutrients. So you observe this slide in detail. I furnish the information. So the nutrients based on nutrition, the individuals are categorized autotrophs and heterotrophs. And next, the chemical substances are present in food material called nutrients. The nutrients mediates energy for vital activity and raw material for growth, repair of tissue and production of gametes and protection from disease. All these are functions of nutrients. And let us, we are going to discuss what are nutrients that are present in our food material. The nutrients are organic or inorganic chemical substances. The organic constituents are biomolecules. They are namely carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, nucleic acids, and vitamins. All these are organic material present in the food. Organic constituents consent to nutrients. So the carbohydrates are chief energy producers. Proteins are bodybuilders. They involve in growth of the body. And lipids are energy reserves. And vitamins are body regulators. Vitamins are termed as body regulators because we consume them in micro quantity, less quantity, but they play a vital role in various metabolic activities. Their deficiency results diseases. That's why they're termed as body regulators. Carbohydrates produce energy, hence they're called chief energy providers. And proteins are involved in growth, hence they're called bodybuilders. And lipids and fats, they're called energy reserve, the excess amount of energy stored in the form of fat, that is in our adipose tissue. So fat storage tissue is adipose tissue. All these things you learn in earlier process. And these are the organic constituents of nutrients. What are the organic constituents of nutrients present in food material? Carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, nucleic acids, and vitamins. These contents are present. So they are also termed as biomolecules. So the food material also include inorganic constituents also. So later we will discuss about inorganic chemical substances. The inorganic chemical substances are minerals and water. You observe this visual. So various kinds of minerals are present: calcium plus 2 ions, magnesium plus 2, sodium plus ions, chloride minus ions, or like that. So various kinds, HCO3 minus ion, various kinds of ions we can intake through the food material into our body. They are minerals. They are also termed as body regulators. Their deficiency results in diseases. Hence, they are called body regulators. Besides that, in daily life, we also consume water also. It is also inorganic constituent of nutrient. The water plays key role in various metabolic activities. So, for example, digestion, it is a hydrolyzing process, compulsory require water. So, it's like that, the water involved in various metabolic activities. So, let us conclude, what is digestion? Depend on... So before going to learn digestion, you observe already we completed about nutrients. So the depend upon quantity of and function of the nutrients, they are categorized macronutrients and micronutrients. The macronutrients, what you observe visual, the carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, nucleic acids comes under category of macronutrients. Macro means major. So we consume them as large quantity. So hence they are called macronutrients. And they require more in quantity to our body. So hence they are called macronutrients. and micronutrients. What are micronutrients? Micro means less. So we consume them in little quantity, and they also require to our body in little amount. So such nutrients are called micronutrients. So the macronutrients and micronutrients. Carbohydrates, protein, lipids and nucleic acids all comes under macronutrients category, and the minerals and water, minerals and vitamins comes under category of micronutrients. Minerals and vitamins comes under category of micronutrient. Let us discuss about the nutrients that are involving in digestion. So two variants of nutrients are there. One variant is macronutrient and another variant is micronutrient. Whatever micronutrient present in the food material, their molecular size is very small, minute. That's why they directly absorb into our body fluid, not need to involve in digestion process. So without digestion, they can directly absorb into body fluid. That is about micronutrients. So if we observed macronutrients already we discussed macronutrients. We consume them as large quantity, and they require larger quantity to our body. They are carbohydrates, proteins, lipids and nucleic acid. These macronutrients molecular size is larger. They are complex molecules there. They never absorbed and utilized by body without digestion. So their molecular size is larger. Due to larger size, across our wall of intestine, they are unable to diffuse into the blood. So they never absorbed. And without digestion, they can't utilize our body. So compulsory required digestion. So what is digestion? The breakdown of complex food molecules into simple substances, simple liquefied material called digestion. What are complex food material? What are complex biomolecules? Macronutrients are complex biomolecules. Micronutrients are simple. Micronutrients are vitamins, minerals, and water. Here macronutrients are carbohydrates, proteins, lipids and nucleic acid. Compulsory they involve in digestion. It is a hydrolytic process in which the breakdown of biomolecules takes place, and ultimately the liquefied simple molecules to be produced. That phenomena is called digestion. So if we observe phenomena of digestion in animals, in heterotrophs, the phenomena of digestion to be noticed as two patterns. One is intracellular digestion and second one is extracellular digestion. You observe visual, the left side visual shows intracellular digestion, the right side image is extracellular digestion. What is intracellular digestion? Intra means inside cell. So the digestion, entire digestion process, entire breakdown of biomolecule, entire breakdown of complex food material mediated inside the cell. So that is intracellular digestion. You observe this visual. In this visual, the food content intake into the cell by phagocytosis mechanism, and food vacuoles to be produced, that to be processed in the cytosol, and intracellular digestion. That is, you observe extracellular digestion. So it is completely differ with intracellular digestion, in which from the cell some secretions are released out. That secretions are going to react with food material. So that food material completely digested, breakdown outside the cell. Later on, the after completion digestion, the food material intake into the cell. So that is difference. So intracellular digestion, in case of intracellular digestion, the digestion completely occur inside the cell. Breakdown completely occurs inside the cell. In case of extracellular digestion, the breakdown of biomolecules takes place outside the cell. That is the difference. So let us we will discuss examples to intra and extracellular digestion. You observe intracellular digestion. It is very primitive kind of digestion. So mostly the primitive animals exhibit intracellular digestion, like protozoans, sponges belongs to phylum Porifera, and cnidarians also exhibit intracellular digestion, but along with intracellular digestion they also exhibit extra dual mode of digestion. But the protozoans and sponges purely exhibit intracellular digestion. Not only these animals, in higher animals also some cells exhibit intracellular digestion. For example, phagocytosis of WBC also comes under this category. So you observe this visual, clear image is there. That is protozoan amoeba. It shows you observe nutrition of the amoeba, you observe the intracellular digestion phenomena in amoeba. So the amoeba consumes a solid form food material with the help of pseudopodia. When the food particles comes in contact with amoeba, then immediately the pseudopodia surrounds the food particle and engulfs the food particle and form a vacuole with the food particle. That phenomena is called phagocytosis. The produced food vacuole is called phagosome. So the food vacuole dropped into cytoplasm of the amoeba. You observe the visual. So later on, the lysosomes, whatever present in the cell, they releases hydrolytic enzymes. More than 40 acid hydrolytic enzymes are present in the lysosomes. So that lysosome surrounds the food vacuole and releases various kinds of hydrolytic enzymes and facilitate the hydrolytic process and digestion, by which all the complex food molecules present in that food material to be break down into simple absorbed material. That simple molecule directly absorbed into cytosol. You observe visual, it clearly given. So after that, undigested food particles contained food vacuole ejected outside the body. So that is mode of intracellular digestion occur in amoeba. In next we will discuss one more example to intracellular digestion. You observe this visual. This is the paramecium, unicellular organism commonly called as slipper animalcule. It also consumes solid food particles. So the solid food particles are entered into the oral route. So it is a ciliary filter feeder, and by the movement of the cilia, the food particles are trapped into oral groove, and oral groove to they enter into cytostome, and afterward from the cytopharynx the food particles are dropped into cytoplasm. Later on they form food vacuoles. So such food vacuoles are associated with the lysosomes, and after action with the digestive enzymes, the food particles completely undergoes digestion, that is intracellular digestion. So this is intracellular digestion method After completion intracellular adhesion, the digested food material to be absorbed into the cytosol, and remaining undigested food particles you observe here, you observe visual cytophyse is there. Through the cytophyse, the undigested food material ejected outside. So that is mode of mechanism of intracellular adhesion that to be occur in paramecium. So next we will discuss one more example to intracellular adhesion. Already I told that not only in primitive individuals like protozoans and sponges, so in higher animals also the intracellular adhesion will be occur in WEC. You observe that clearly it is white blood corpuscle, that is neutrophils. So that neutrophils, they are commonly called as microscopic policemen, fastest moving WBC, and highest phagocytic in nature. So whenever bacteria contact, immediately such bacteria to be engulfed by the neutrophil and prominent food vacuole to be produced, that is phagosome, and that is processed by the enzyme activity released by the lysosomes, and intracellular adhesion. So it is one more example. Now we are going to discuss about the mechanism of intracellular adhesion. So in intracellular adhesion, according to consumption of the food material, two kinds of vacuoles to be produced: phagocytosis, pinocytosis. Phagocytosis means if solid food particles whether consumed, that is phagocytosis. If liquid content consumed into the cell, that is called pinocytosis. You observe here solid food material, food particles are present. That food particles are entered into the cytosol by the invagination of the plasma membrane. A food vacuole is produced. So that is phagocytosis phenomena. The produced food vacuole is called phagosome. You observe, clear visual is there, phagosome is produced. For example, instead of solid food material, whether liquefied material intake into the cell, that is pinocytosis. The produced vacuole is called pinosome. Phagosomes are contain solid food particles, pinosomes contain liquid food contents. That is the difference. Phagosomes, pinosomes. Phagocytosis, pinocytosis. So whatever it may be, ultimately by phagocytosis, pinocytosis, food vacuoles are produced in the cytosol. So when food vacuoles are produced, they are going to associated with lysosomes. Lysosomes are aggregated around the food vacuole and releases various secretions, and such secretions are breakdowns the complex food material. After breakdown the complex food material, the simple molecules to be absorbed into cytosol. Remaining undigested food particles called residual bodies there. The residual bodies contained vacuoles to be ejected outside. Sometimes in some cells they to be stored in the cytosol. So this is mechanism of intracellular digestion. So the digestion modes are two variants. One is intracellular digestion, and second one is extracellular digestion. The primitive individuals are expect intracellular digestion. So example, protozoans and sponges. We verified the examples to intracellular digestion. One example, digestion in amoeba, and another example, paramecium, and third example, intracellular digestion, WBC, and ultimately we discussed the mechanism of intracellular digestion. So another variant is extracellular adhesion. The extracellular adhesion performed by advanced individuals from nidaria onward up to caudates, all individuals are exhibit extracellular adhesion. So it is advanced mechanism. So it is the adhesion process occur outside the cell. So in next class we are going to discuss about the extracellular adhesion, extracellular adhesion. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.